recently, I've had the good fortune of spending a lot of time in nature. And while I've always enjoyed being outside, these little moments of green and quiet have meant more in the last few weeks. Some of that is because these days, outside is the main place I get to go besides my apartment. But it's not just that. In the last few weeks, I've also come to notice, or maybe re-notice, because this doesn't feel entirely new, how ordinary things are at the same time entirely improbable and completely inevitable. Take these little wildflowers. They're called spring beauties, and I've seen them all over the place in the last few years, but it wasn't until recently that I really started noticing them, and then, of course, I wanted to know more. Turns out, these flowers are found all across the eastern half of the United States and Canada, and they're also called fairy spuds because they grow tiny, edible, potato-like tubers. Knowing just that is satisfying to me because I like naming and knowing the stories of things, and learning that people all around North America are probably enjoying these flowers right now is a welcome bit of connection. But as I was working on this video, I also learned that spring beauties are just as strange as they are lovely. So, science lesson here. Most plants have a consistent number of chromosomes. Chromosomes are basically chunks of genetic material, and typically most members of a species have about the same number of them. On average, that's actually really important for an organism's health. Like, humans typically have 46, but sometimes a person might have 47 or 45. Spring beauties, meanwhile, don't follow those rules. They don't have a consistent number of chromosomes at all. Like, some plants have 16 of them, and others have 24, and apparently, some have 190. So far, we've mapped out more than 50 possible options. This is not a thing that normally happens with healthy plants, and we don't know how these ones pull it off so successfully. Something about that is just deeply cool to me. We don't understand these flowers, and they defy the huge pattern we see in nature, and yet, they're here every spring, spreading across huge pieces of North America, both entirely improbable and completely inevitable. I love that, and in these weird times, it also brings me some degree of comfort. Like, no matter what happens, there will always be ordinary, extraordinary things in the world. And I don't know, for me, that's just kind of reassuring. Honestly, I didn't intend to make this video about spring beauties. I intended to go into a little patch of forest, admire the plants I found there, and maybe make a video about how much perspective and peace I found from being outside. But here we are. Sometimes the world is too interesting to be confined by me and my ideas, and I am completely okay with that. So, thanks, wildflowers, and I'm sorry I ever underestimated you.